स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम टू अकाउंटेंसी क्लास। आई एम नरसिम्हलु, कॉमर्स टीचर। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू सीईसी फर्स्ट ईयर अकाउंटेंसी। इन द अकाउंटेंसी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक जर्नलाइजिंग अकाउंटिंग ट्रांजैक्शंस इन द बुक जर्नल। स्टूडेंट्स यू ऑल नो दैट देर आर three types of accounts, namely personal account, real account and nominal account, and these accounts also have their own principles. These principles are called as golden principles of accounting. So what are they? See, personal account principle: receiver account should be debited, giver account should be credited. And come to real account principle: debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Come to nominal account principle: expenses, losses, costs should be debited, incomes, revenues, profit should be credited. Okay students, so these are the three accounts and their principles, which are useful for analyzing the business transaction or accounting transaction for writing the journal entry in the journal. And here you also know that as per dual aspect concept, every business transaction will have two aspects. Here, in order to writing the journal entry in the book of journal, we need to find two aspects in the given accounting transaction. Right, see here, it is the transaction that has been given in this here, 4th January 2018, goods sold to Rani for cash rupees 20,000. Once again, you see here the transaction: 4th January 2018, goods sold to Rani for cash rupees 20,000. It is one accounting transaction. In this transaction, we need to find two aspects. See, to find the aspects, we need to ask some questions in our mind. What are they? First one, you ask one question in your mind, that is there any name in the accounting transaction? Yes, there is the name. So Rani is the name, make it underline. It is one aspect. Okay students, come to next one. You ask one more question, that in your mind, is there any income or expenditure in the given accounting transaction? No, no such expenditure, no such income in this transaction. Simply ignore. And come to third question that you have to ask yourself in your mind, that is there any asset in the given transaction? Yes, goods, okay, it is asset. And come to cash also asset, both are assets, goods and cash, both are assets. And Ravi, name of a person. Rani, that is Rani, name of a person. Okay, here when you find three aspects in a transaction, and here you keep one thing in your mind, that cash and name are given in the problem, then you give importance to cash but not the name of a person. Here simply you ignore the name of a person when the word cash you see in the transaction along with another aspect. Okay students, so here it is also called as cash transaction. This transaction is called as cash transaction. When it is a cash transaction and we find three aspects in the transaction, then we can go to ignore or omit the name of a person. So then we will have only two aspects: one is goods, another is cash. So cash also asset, goods also assets. And here you think in your mind, assets related to which account? Assets related to real account. So assets comes under real account. So here you can go to write real account. Assets comes under real account. Here also your cash is asset, so you write a real account.
After that, here apply the principle of real account. What comes in debit, what goes out credit. So as per the real account principle, when we sold the goods to Rani for cash, then is goods coming into the business or is goods going out of the business? Yes, that is correct. When we sell, naturally the goods go from our business. So whatever that goes from the business, that should be credited. Here goes out. What is going out here? Goods, good sales. Or you can go to write sales, sale of goods, sale of goods account. You can go to write credit. Sale of goods account should be credited because goods going out of the business. And come to another aspect, that is cash. Cash comes under, cash can be treated as a as an asset. Assets comes under real account. Real account principle is what comes in debit, what goes out credit. So when we purchase the, when we sell the goods for cash, is cash coming into the business or is cash going out of the business? Yes, that's correct. Cash coming into the business. We are giving goods and we receiving cash. When we receiving cash, cash comes into the business. So whatever that comes into the business should be debited as per real account principle. So here comes in. So cash account debit. Okay students, after this process you can go to make in your mind, or this process you can go to do in your working notes, and then we can go to write the journal entry in the journal. What is the entry? See, first you can go to write date in the date column. 2018 January 4th. 2018 January 4th. Okay, what is that entry? Debit account. First you can go to write cash account debit. Here you write cash account debit. In the debit column again is this account amount rupees 20,000. And credit account you can go to write. What is the credit account here? Sale of goods or sales account. Both are accepted. Sales account or sale of goods account. Both are accepted. Whatever you like, you can go to write it here. And in the credit column, you can go to write amount rupees 20,000. And here, after writing the debit and credit account in the journal, next you can go to write narration. Here the narration is goods sold for cash, being goods sold for cash. So students, here we're not giving importance in the narration also. We are not given the name, we are not given importance to name even in the transaction, because it is a cash transaction. We must give importance to cash than name of the person in the cash transaction. When we are given another as three aspects in the same business or accounting transaction, so like this we can go to write narration. What is the narration here? Being goods sold for cash. Once again we can go to observe the process and how we wrote the entry in the journal. Here the tips and tricks that you have to remember in your mind. First one, you should know three types of accounts and their principles. Second, you must know the dual aspect concept and applying the dual aspect concept in the given business transaction. We need to identify two aspects. After identifying two aspects, you can go to find the nature of aspects. Means here, is it a name of a person or is it a expenditure or is it income or is it a asset. So after finding the nature of those aspects, then you can go to consider it to related account. So after finding the appropriate account of the concerned aspect, you can go to apply the principle of such account. Then you find debit account as well as credit account. Okay. So simply, first you can go to find two aspects in the business transaction, then
think that the aspects related to which account or which the asset aspects comes under which accounts, and you can go to use the account principle and find debit account and credit account. After finding debit and credit account, you can go to write the journal entry in the journal. First date, then entry, then narration. Like this, we can go to complete the entire process of recording journal entry in the journal. And this process is called as journalizing accounting transactions. Journalizing accounting transactions. Okay, students, I hope you understood how to write the journal entry for the given cash transaction. For the given cash transaction. Okay, thank you for watching this video.